Hello there, it's Ren, your local university student and learning enthusiast. Today, I'm back with another review of an insanely underrated app that'll help you ace all those tests or memorize all the information that you've been trying to master. Also, make sure to stick around until the end of today's video because I have a really important channel update announcement. Okay, so as we all know, one of the best ways to study is by testing yourself, or something we like to call active recall. A really efficient way to learn with active recall is by using flashcards. So far, we've been through some of the more complex apps that require somewhat of a learning curve, like RemNote and Neurocache, and of course, a fan favorite, Anki, which I have yet to make videos for on the channel. All of the above will take you a while to learn how to use. I have tutorials on RemNote, but the fact that I have to make tutorials on these apps means that it's really difficult to learn them, or at least it takes a long time. This app today is completely different. It's called Feyn, possibly the simplest app out there that you can find, and it's named after the Feynman technique, which is attributed to Richard Feynman. This technique basically says that in order to understand something, you must be able to explain it. Hence using flashcards to be able to explain things to yourself. The app doesn't say anything about this technique, but I reached out to the creator of the app and he verified that the name was indeed based off of Richard Feynman. So, who is this app for? Honestly, it's for anyone who doesn't have enough time to learn how to use a more complicated app, or if you're just looking for something simple that will get the job done. Now, here's the biggest pro to the app. I can guarantee that it'll take you about 2 seconds to learn and absolutely understand how to use it, meaning that you can get started with creating cards and studying right away after you download it. It contains the absolute bare bones of active recall, and honestly, I kind of love the simplicity and minimalism of it. The interface is super intuitive and clean, and it lets you do all the basics. Another big pro I'm sure you guys want to know is that this app is 100% free. It's always great to see free apps built for students because, as you know, we don't always have the budget to pay for such expensive tools. In this video, I'll go over the features of the app and compare it to a few of its most popular competitors and where I think this app stands in the market as of right now. As always, you'll find the timestamps for this video in the description as well as links to everything I mention. For now, let me show you around my current setup while using this app. My laptop typically sits right in front of me along with my monitor so that I can refer to some diagrams and information, with my iPad below me so that I can write everything down on my handy flashcards. Just a tiny plug, the lovely company Andar was kind enough to send me this really high quality leather case for my MacBook, which is called the Helm, and I have absolutely been loving it so far. I'm not being paid to say any of this, but the links for purchasing the case are down below, so feel free to check them out if you're interested. Just giving you a quick review of the case itself. First of all, the packaging and unboxing experience was just amazing. There was this really nice bag that came along with it that you can put your laptop into. You also get a nice little coupon for your next purchases. You get a really cute little sticker, and I love collecting stickers, so I'll definitely be keeping this one. You also get a nice black bag that I was really afraid to rip the entire time. And then you get the case itself. And once you open it up, there is a really strong smell of leather. And I'm personally not the biggest fan of the smell of leather, and I never have been ever since I was little, but I do know that a lot of people absolutely love the smell of leather. So if that's you, I would definitely take a look into these cases. The case is split up into two parts and really easy to assemble and put on because everything just slides and snaps together. I also really love the clean aesthetic of it. I haven't had any problems of my laptop overheating yet, which is a concern that I did have. And if you typically like to go for a really professional and sleek look, I think this is something you might want to consider. The leather is super smooth and high quality, so check it out if you'd like. All right, so let's now dive back into our review of the features of Feyn. So this app is available for iOS devices on the App Store, which is extremely unfortunate for my Android friends out there. I'm so sorry about that. This is definitely one of the gripes that I have with this app, and again, I'll talk more about that later. But ideally, you would download this onto your iPad and your iPhone as well, so that you can review content on the go. All right, so the app was actually recently updated, which is really great to know that the developers are still working on the app and they just haven't completely ignored it. So at least you know that you'll be expecting some nice updates on this app, and Feyn is working hard on getting those out to you guys. So I'm gonna give you guys a really quick walkthrough of basically what the app is about. If we start over here at the top left-hand corner, we'll see that there is a general menu button, and now here on the screen you can see all of the flashcards that I have already created. So if you go ahead and click on this top left-hand corner, you can see all the folders you've created, and this folder update is a new one. I believe it was highly requested by a lot of users, so I guess the creator decided to do that. I personally found it enough to just use the tagging system, so I'll explain that in a little bit as well. But you do have different folders that you can create. So if you click over here in the bottom left-hand corner, you can see that you can create a new folder. And here I'll just type anything in. For example, I type math there. And now you have a folder showing up called math. So now you can add certain things to this folder. You can click the plus button in the top right hand corner, whip out your pen and start writing. So math card example, and press this button to flip. Hello, for instance. And now you have created this card. So you can exit it and the math card example card shows up in this math folder. So that's a super convenient way to do it. You can now also review specific cards from this folder. So now if you click up here in the top right hand corner, you realize that there is one card in this specific folder. And now this is the timed space repetition system that they have built into the app, which is always super helpful for when you're doing some long-term studying. You always want to have this clicked. But if you're not doing long-term studying, if you see this little infinity sign right here, go ahead and click on this, and this is the cram button. It's really helpful. You can go through all of your cards without worrying about the space repetition, and it won't space out your cards. So you can review them all, for example, in the same night before your exam. All right, so now how to review this card is you first read the question that's on the front side that we have right here, and then when you think you know the answer, you can guess it and tap to flip it to the back side. Once you get it correct, you actually swipe up on the card and it gives you that little check mark, or you can swipe down on the card, which means you got it wrong. So let's say we got it correct, you'll swipe up and it'll tell you that you don't have any cards left scheduled for space repetition today. So that was simple enough. We can return back into the folder here now and go back into this little menu. Once we go here, you'll see that there is also an option for you to go into your settings here. This settings folder is basically where you enable your iCloud sync. So this app actually directly syncs to your iPhone, which is super helpful. You can review things on the go, which is always wonderful. So let me show you guys how that works right here, since we're on the subject. So now we've got the Feyn app open on the iPhone, and as you can see, this is what they implemented in the most recent update. Super helpful once again. So as you can see, we've got all of our cards here on the Feyn app natively, which is super, super helpful at all times. And another super helpful thing, if I don't want to review all of these cards at once, is to go here into the same folders that I've created through iCloud. And as you can see, we've got the math folder. We can click on the math folder and edit this card or review it or do any of that. So everything else is also available on your phone, and you can do the exact same thing on your phone as you can with the iPad, except without the complications of the Apple Pencil. Okay, so heading back onto the iPad, we are in this same systems page, and you can see that I was using on my phone actually dark mode. I like not having my eyes burn in the morning when I wake up, so that's just something that I have enjoyed on my phone, but I usually keep my iPad on light mode. So what you can do is just turn it on to system mode, which is what you've assigned to your system. So sometimes you can do on your Apple systems, you can change it to be light mode during the day and night mode at night. So if you're something like that, then this totally works. I just have it on system just in case someday I decide to do that. Currently, my iPad is on light mode at all times, but if you want to, you can always switch between light mode and dark mode, and it does that very quickly. Super smooth, great user experience, but for now I'll keep it on system. All right, so the button below this is the tutorial button, where you can get some of the tutorials for basically everything going on in the app. They tell you a little bit about the fine learning method, they tell you about the reviewing techniques, about the crams, everything like that. So it's just a super simple app. Honestly, after watching this video, you should be able to understand most of it. But if you don't, you know, that's always there for you to access. So make sure to look at those if you're ever confused about whatever you're doing. And down here is just a way for you to contact the developers and creators for Feyn. I know they are working super hard behind the scenes and turning out all of these updates, and I really appreciate them for that. I also know that they definitely love to hear all of your feedback, so definitely make sure to use this and reach out to them if you ever get the chance. Now, moving on to the tagging system. This is one of the best features of Feyn in my opinion, and it adds a little bit more customizability to what you would usually probably not find in a very simple app like this. So when you come in here, you got a few tags: biology, chemistry, physiology, and probability. And here, if we look in my physiology tag, I can come in here and see all of my cards that have been tagged under physiology. So that's just a helpful way for you to review cards within cards. So a tip that I would have for this is to review things by exam. So I would probably filter something under physiology, but also filter it under exam one, for example. So if you do that, and you create a new tag called exam one, which I will do right now, then now you've got exam one and physiology. So in your physiology exam one, you can go ahead and check both of these, but then in your physiology cards, which is one of these, for example, if I have this one on exam one, I can go ahead and tag it under exam one as well, and then I can review it within my exam one tags. So when I untag this physiology one, I can still see it in exam one and only go through the cards that are in exam one. So review here, and I'm only reviewing for exam one. I can do that in either cram mode or the spaced repetition mode. So super convenient. It's really, really great to be able to have that customizability with the tagging feature. So if you're not into using the folder system that they've got here, you always have the tagging available. It might get a little bit more complicated, but I do think that it's an added feature that will help you out in the long run. Now, moving on, we can go ahead and look at the plus feature here, which is how you add a card. And now they've got it adding to this all cards folder. So just be aware of where you're adding the cards to. You would usually just be able to add cards within a specific folder you want to, but once again, you could just add it in this all cards feature. So basically it works exactly as your Apple Notes app would work. I've got a blue pen selected here. If we go on here with the black pen, you know how it works. It's just the same as Apple Notes. Literally the same idea, super simple, not much to understand. You got the pen, you got the highlighter, you got the pencil, you got the eraser and the select tool, and of course the ruler. So you've got all of that going for you. And then all you gotta do once you're done writing the question on the front, you can go ahead and click this button in the top right hand corner and go on to the answer. So you can write the answer here. So once you're finished creating your card, you got the front, of course, and the back, you can go ahead and click on these three little dots right here. Once you click on that, you can see your spaced repetition process. Here, you can also reset your learning progress. And something to note is that you have a recall period of 10 minutes, and it'll tell you when your review is due. So right now it's due for now because we haven't reviewed this yet, but you can also select if it shows you the front side first or if it shows you a random side. I'd usually go with the front side unless it's something like language. If you're learning Spanish or learning a foreign language, something like that, you can figure out the word and what it means. But for your typical learning purposes, for academics, I would say that the front side is usually what you would go with here. Now, for some more detail, here you can assign it to one of your folders, and that can be helpful whenever you want to put it in that category. You can also hide the background grid if that's something you want to do, but very simple, very straightforward. Up here, you've got the tags where you can select which card to tag it with, and then you're finished. You can create another one by pressing this plus button here, and you get a whole new screen. Once you're done with that, just go back and hit the back button. So for building a workflow for this app, I suggest that you use it during your downtime. For example, if you're in the car or if you're at school and you just have some time in between classes or you're taking a break from something, this is a perfect time to just whip out your phone if you're sitting in public transit or something like that, and you can just go over and study some of your cards. I also do suggest that you actually make a planner depending on when you have an exam so that you can review them at least a few days leading up to the exam, and also depending on how many days, weeks, or months you need to review in advance. So the best way to implement this would be to follow my study routine video, which you can find in the card in the upper right-hand corner of this video, and it'll also be linked down below. And in that video, I explain in way much more depth about how to space out your studying and how to actually make a routine for yourself to make sure that you're being effective while using any of these apps. If you like that simple and straightforward studying style without too many complications, this is for you. I have a few improvement suggestions that I would like to see this app have in the future, but remember that this app is still in its early stages, so honestly we don't have too much to complain about. The first thing I would suggest is to add in that Android support for all of my Android friends out there. I got you guys and I totally understand your pain. So hopefully the developers will possibly consider creating an Android version of this app in the future. Aesthetics-wise, I would love to see some themes or some other customizability choices in the future, in addition to the typical light mode and dark mode, and I think that would just be a quality of life thing. So just as a form of closing out for this video before we get to the long-awaited channel announcement, if you're still here, thank you so much for sticking around. We'll get to that very soon. But should you download this app? So in conclusion, Feyn is fine. Oh man, I'm sorry for that. But in the end, it totally depends on your own preferences. I'm personally only planning on using this app in the future for anything I might need to learn that involves drawings, since I can draw out diagrams on my own and add labels however I'd like. Other than that though, I personally think that this app is a little too simple for my studying purposes, but I know that many people out there might appreciate this video as a little introduction to an app that's a lot easier to figure out and a lot quicker to get started on. So hopefully you enjoyed this review and tutorial. Now, for our long-awaited channel announcement, I wanted to let you guys know where this channel will be going in the future. I am starting daily live streaming. Yep, you heard it right. I am going to be studying and streaming myself here on YouTube every day for almost 12 hours per day. I have been uploading a bit less frequently lately and have been really looking forward to getting back in touch with all of you guys, so this is a perfect way for us to chat and study together. I will leave the link for the stream schedule in the description, so definitely check that out and see if you can join us. It should work if you're in any time zone. I also have all the time zones listed, so you'll know exactly what each of the times mean. But that's it for today. If this video helped you out in any way or you had a good time watching it, I would really appreciate it if you could leave a like for me and a comment to let me know what you think. Also, please don't forget to subscribe and turn on those notifications to know when I go live for my Study With Me streams. Thank you so much, everybody, for all of your support, and I will see you all next time.